Hey, this is Josh McClain with ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be doing a Legacy Cube Draft. So here's our first pack here. This pack is not too bad. Tempted to take Cryptic Command because it's one of the better cards here. I kind of want to take Hollowed Fountain, but I'm going to go ahead and take Cryptic and go from there. Gives us a direction to start with, so. Let's see. Debating between Jace and Moldrifter here. I think I want to take Jace. Jace. Generally, Planeswalkers are pretty good. Jace is not one of the better ones, but pretty solid. Take Breeding Pool, Cyclonic Rift, Baneslayer Angel. I think I'm gonna take Breeding Pool. It's like having a reasonable mana base. Fraile, Sower's pretty good. Tasker's obviously good. So Dragonlord Silmgar, just a bigger Sower. I like Fraile's a lot, but I think it's not quite as good in this cube because there's not like, a bunch of Signets and stuff. So I think I'm just going to take Sower. If I knew I was going to be blue-black, I'd probably take the Dragonlord instead. But as is, I'm just going to take the single blue card. Well, double blue, but color-wise. Could have also taken maybe the temple, but let's see. Frumbeon's not terrible. We have a bunch of 4-drops already. Garrett could be good. Probably just going to end up taking temple here. Bloodred Elf is obviously decent, but and so far we have 2 double blue and a triple blue card, so I want to be heavy blue most likely. So I'm going to go ahead and take temple here, still leaves us open. And depending on my deck, I'd even play an off-color Scryland. Let's see. Nothing too spectacular in this pack. I guess Elvish Mystic's pretty good. It's not, it doesn't really help with our ridiculously blue-heavy costs, but it's still a solid card. Top is obviously good, but it's pretty hard to get a decent amount of shuffle effects. I mean, fetches are pretty high picks, and there's not that much else, so I'm just going to take the Elvish Mystic. I already have a Breeding Pool too, so. Profane Command's very good. Kiora's decent too. Another 4-drop, but I think I'm probably going to take Kiora here. There's Tree Speaker, but I guess Tree Speaker's pretty good too. I could take that. Again, it's not helping us cast, Jace or Sower, but I mean, you still can just play Forest on turn one and then Island and cast those spells, but I'm going to take Tree Speaker. We also could end up in like a green ramp deck. We don't have to play these blue cards if it turns out we get some other stuff. Let's see. Take Probe. Eternal Dragon is not terrible. I could take Pod. I could end up in like a, if I end up with a decent curve of creatures. I think I'm going to take Pod. It's unlikely that I'm going to play it, but I don't love, I mean, Probe is just fine, but Pod has a lot higher payoff. If my deck is good for Pod, Pod's going to be fantastic. Whereas Probe is just going to be like an okay card no matter what. So I think I'm going to take Battlesphere again because it's a decent top end if I end up with the pod deck. I could also take the Temple. I'm tempted to take the Temple, but I'll take Battlesphere. Battlesphere's just, even if I end up with like a slow control deck, Battlesphere's not bad, or the ramp deck. So Battlesphere's actually just decent in all the decks that I'm constructing here. I'm just going to take this Mana Gorger Hydra. It's not that bad. I'm unlikely to play it, but if I absolutely need a 3 to pot into, it's not terrible. I like Primal Command. I've always liked this card. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Temple here. Vengevine's a good one to pot into. Well, it's okay, I guess. I mean, to sacrifice it, but then you obviously have to have two creatures to trigger it. I'm going to take the Kami here. It's, if I end up, you know, with a white splash in the deck, Kami's a good option to have if I play pod. Just, you know, it's a good card to have in the deck in case I need it. It's looking like I'm probably not going to be playing this Cryptic Command. I'm a little, you know, not as blue heavy as I'd like. I'm still probably going to play Sower and maybe Jace. I mean, Sower's just good, especially if I'm potting. It's a decent card. I can pot into Sower, steal their guy, and then next turn sack their guy to my pod. Whirler Rogue's a great one to pot into. Let's see. The Sphinx, obviously a birthing pot all-star. Lanar Elf is good. I think the Allure is pretty good too. Dragon Predator. I think I'm going to take the Whirler Rogue though. It's just an absolutely fantastic card to pot into. Although I don't really want another double blue spell, so maybe I'll take Sphinx instead. I hate first picking Finks here. I feel like it'll probably wheel. Maybe I'll take Lanar Elf. It's pretty strong to have a one drop accelerator. This will give us 3, which is, you know, decently likely we'll have it on turn 1. Yeah, I hope the Finks, the Predator, or the Whirler Rogue wheel. Yeah, I'm gonna take the Lanar Elf. Greedworn to Morass, that's a decent one to pot into. Nothing else in this pack is super exciting. It's like Compulsive Research, which is okay, but I'm going to take Greedworn. It's also just a good value card. Stomp Howler's good. Avenger's pretty good. Dragonlord Target's a decent one to pot into. It's also just a Verdant Catacombs, which would help our mana. So it gets both green and blue. I think I'm going to take Stomp Howler, though. I like the card a lot, and it's a great, you know, it's a good option to have for pod. We don't have any 5 drops right now. So I'm going to take it. I think I'm going to take the Hinterland Harbor, just for our mana. Waterfront Bouncer, not terrible. And Hangerback Walker, I mean, it's not the greatest card to sacrifice to pod, but it's not horrible. There are a lot of situations where if you draw that, you should make a 4/4. If it's later in the game and then sack it, get an Elvish Mystic, something to start up the chain, but it does give you, you know, 4 Thopters or whatever. But that being said, I'm just going to take Hinterland Harbor. Collected Company. Ooh, Edric. A Collected Company, obviously, I don't think we really have enough creatures to make that work, especially if we're, you know, building a deck with pod in mind. I'm going to have a couple 4, 5, and 6 drops, etc. So I'm going to take Edric here. Edric's great with our, you know, our mana guys. Turn 2 Edric is pretty strong, especially if, you know, on turn 3 we can play like a Sower or something just to get rid of their blocker. But Pian Kira Nalar is a great card to pot into. Little red might be a bit tough. Or double red, rather. I do have a Temple of Epiphany here, so single red cards wouldn't be that hard. I'm going to take the Overgrown Battlement. Like I said, I'm still kind of a ramp deck, too. You know, Pod is still going to be great in this deck, because I still have, you know, I'm going to have all these ramp creatures, or all these mana creatures that I don't need anymore. Or, if my draw doesn't have a big spell, if I draw Pod, I can use the mana creatures to start getting real creatures, so. Harmonize is pretty good. Upheaval. Upheaval's pretty good with just a bunch of mana. I think I want to take Harmonize, though. Again, if my hand is like a bunch of mana guys, just having a Harmonize to refill after I play all these 1/1s is nice. This Pod is kind of a 3-drop. Disciple of Bolas isn't terrible to Pod into. But you draw cards equal to its toughness and gain life. No, it's only its power. So it's not fantastic. I might just take Godless Shrine. No, I'm gonna take Disciple of Bolas. I could end up playing. If I end up playing black, okay, well, Fink's Wield, so that's good. Definitely gonna take that. Take Blood Artist here. I mean, it's possible I end up just like green black splashing blue for like Edric. I mean, I could, and if I do that, then I still probably don't really want to play Blood Artist. I'm gonna take Sorin. If somehow I end up in a deck, Sorin's actually really good. You know, if I somehow end up being able to cast it. Let's see. I think I'm gonna take the Dragon Lord of Tarka. A pretty solid way to end my curve. I have that and Mirror Battlesphere. Especially if I have all this ramp. I'm not playing any of those. I'll collect Company Wield, but I really don't think we're gonna be able to play this. I'll take it just in case pack 3 goes weirdly and I get a bunch, just a bunch of 2 and 3 drops that are good. Maybe I can board that in. Alright. It's nice we have this temple so I can, it's a little easier to cast this Dragon Lord as well. Okay, a few cards I want in this pack. Taiga, Temple Garden, if I end up wanting to play a white spell. Deceiver is pretty good with Pod. Wood Elves is pretty good with Pod. And this is just a great card. Especially if we're in this rampish, like ramp aggro deck. It's kind of a weird archetype, but just like kind of like an early Vengevine or Indrik Stompowler. It's kind of more of like a mid rangey deck, and Nissa's pretty good in that. I think I'm gonna take Nissa. I have 4 ramp spells right now. I would really like 1 or 2 more. Maybe either this Wood Elf or this Deceiver will wheel. I'd really like one of them. I mean, I guess Dragon Lord Ojutai is pretty good too. I don't have any white lands, but if maybe I wheel the Temple Garden, I could splash Ojutai. I mean, I can either pot into it, or if I draw it, I can maybe cast it. Hornet Queen, but I already have enough 7 drops, so I don't really need the Hornet Queen. I think I'm either going to take Nissa or Wood Elves, and I think I'm going to take Nissa. Hopefully I get 1 or 2 more ramp spells. Geyser St. Trap's pretty good, but we're already Not likely to be able to cast it easily. Baleth is pretty good for us. I already have a lot of 4 drops. Wake Thrasher's not terrible. Ugin's actually pretty great. Might just take that. Sucks it's not like a good creature, but just take Eldrazi Monument. That doesn't seem very good. I think I'm just gonna go with Ugin. My curve's getting a little high. I really need another cheap ramp creature or two. Let's see, so it's a Bayou to help us play this Disciple. I'm probably just not going to play this Disciple, so just take that out. Was Primeval Titan. I'm probably going to take Primeval Titan here. is that, or like maybe in Special Visions or Keranos. I think I can pot into Keranos, that's kind of sweet. But I think I'm just going to take Primeval Titan. There's no ramp creatures, but I'm pretty happy with the Wall of Blossoms. You know, it fills a 2-drop. It's actually kind of a ramp creature if I have Overgrown Battlement, but also just a good card, you know, play it on turn 2, draw a card, and then pot it away on turn 4 or whatever. Solid, so. Let's see, Cura's Follower, perfect. God, either Pestermite or Reclamation Sage, both are pretty good for us. Pestermite plays the same role as Deceiver, you know, I can pot into that, untap pot, and then pot into one of my 4-drops. So I really would like another 5-drop so I don't have just the Stomp Howler. You know, I've got at least 2 creatures at every other spot on the curve. But obviously, taking Follower can even, like, use Pod twice in the same turn. Okay, so there's a Fauna Shaman or a Search for Demar here. I'm pretty sure I'm going to take Search. Just, again, kind of cementing us in this ramp deck. Like, I have lots of powerful cards on my top end, so I just want to be able to cast them as soon as possible. I have 4 ways to essentially play a turn 1 accelerator. It's pretty solid. So I have a lot of cheap creatures. You know, I have 6 that cost 2 or less to help this Vengevine. Let's see. Tooth and Nail? I don't think that's too good for us. Like, I already have plenty of big stuff. Like, yeah, obviously if I'm ever casting it with Entwine, it's probably going to win me the game, just getting, you know, a target Battlesphere, but I could also take Gilded Lotus. Gilded Lotus just gets us right to, I mean, if I just cast Gilded Lotus, I can immediately cast any of these. Oh, I think I'm just going to take Den Protector, though. That card's just pretty great. What does this guy do again? Oh, yeah. That's not bad either. Something I can cast early, get a couple counters on it, and then pot it away. Make some Island Walkers. But I think I'm just going to take Den Protector. It's just a great card. Gifts and Givens. Does that really do anything for us? Not really. Stormtide Leviathan gives me an 8-drop to pot it into. It's also just a great card. Well, it was great in normal limited formats. It's probably much less great in this format, but it's a little expensive. Well, I don't think I'm really going to play any of the rest of these. Imperial Recruiter would be not terrible, but it's way too hard to cast. Gifts I don't think is very good. I'm just going to take Stormtide Leviathan. It's really good, and especially like mid-range mirrors, so I can board it in there, you know, if I need an 8-drop to bring in. So I'll take the Taiga. Yeah, it's helped me cast this Dragon Lord. So that or Hornet Queen. Again, Hornet Queen's really good in these mid-range mirrors, but I've already got enough big stuff, I think. See. Wake Thrasher. It's not a horrible card. Brutal Expulsion, I could splash that. I think I'm just going to take Wake Thrasher here. Stratotancer's pretty good. I'm happy that wield. Almost for sure gonna play it. Ripbound Craig, some more fixing. Ooh, Pestermite wield, that's nice. I think I would have rather had Deceiver, but not by much. Domri. I thought about Domri for a little bit the first time around. The deck is mostly creatures. Let's see here. Probably not going to play in this Wake Thrasher. So this is 27 cards here. So I want to play probably 17 lands. I mean, I have a lot of mana sources, so I could play 16, but I also have, you know, an 8-drop and 2 7-drops in my deck. So, and I have some mana sinks. Like I have Pod, Harmonize, Nissa, Green Warden. All those I need a lot of mana to really make use of. I'm probably not going to play this Domri. It's a little hard to cast, and I don't have that many creatures in my deck. Mostly it's just going to be hard to cast reliably on like turn 3, so. I could cut Mana Gorger Hydra. I have to cut like 3 more cards. Okay, well first, let me look at my curve of creatures, make sure it works with Pod. So I have pretty much I didn't end up getting another 5-drop, which is unfortunate, but hopefully I just, it won't be a problem. So let's see. I can definitely afford to cut a 2-drop. Well, I guess these are both 3s, really. Well, Stratus Dancer, I'm way more likely to play on 2 than Den Protector. But Stratus Dancer could really go either way, depending on how my curve looks. But Den Protector, I really want to be playing on 3 in this format. I guess Pestermite maybe isn't great, because I really don't have that many, you know, awesome 4-drops to just go, you know, wall into Sower or Vengevine or whatever. It's like, that's okay, but not fantastic. I think I'm going to cut it. Just got 2 more yet. So this basically goes here. I think I'm going to cut Jace. It's double blue, and it's not great in my deck. Mostly just because it's double blue. Like, Sower's double blue, but I can also pot into that. I do think I want to play Jace, just because, you know, with my deck having a lot of ramp spells, any card draw is pretty good. So now I'm just going to move these into, like, threats rather than creatures. So I have no removal or any reactive spells, so I'm going to have to... But I mean, that's fine. Like, my deck is all sorcery speed giant stuff, so I'm just going to make a big threat every turn, you know, starting on turn 4. I think I'm going to cut Mana Gorger Hydra. I'm not casting that many spells. Well, I really only have 2 good 3-drops to pot into now, but that's okay. I want to cut one more. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 6 essentially mana sources that aren't lands. So I could probably get away with 16 lands. Yeah, I think I'm going to play 16. I really, you know, I have some mana sinks, but flooding is certainly a way I could see often losing. Because if I draw, you know, to hand that's just like 2 ramp spells, 4 lands, and then 1 big spell, and they deal with my big spell, and I just draw a land and, you know, a Stratus Dancer or something, and another land or two, just some of my irrelevant creatures, things can go wrong. So I think I'm just going to play 16. Let's see. I definitely want one mountain for my search for tomorrow. No more than that. I don't need a plains, that's just because of Kitchen Finks. And then I think I want 2 islands. So this way I can search up a Jace or Sower as needed. So that gives me 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 green sources. I can probably actually go down a forest and plus another island. So then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so that gives me 7 blue sources. What did I say? So 12 green sources, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11 green sources, 7 blue sources, and 4 red sources, but then I also have, you know, Overgrown Battlement, or sorry, Search for Tomorrow to get my other colors. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Alright, so we'll be starting the round here shortly.